Hello, friends and family. Welcome to Netcode-Hub channel. So it is actually a great pleasure to say welcome to this channel. Now, you know, this is Netcode-Hub, and this channel facilitates on .NET lessons and projects. So you can subscribe to this channel. You can also check the channel playlist. We have a lot of lessons and projects that you can watch. In this video, we are going to talk about how to create autocomplete. Instead of how to create or how to use an autocomplete in your project when using .NET Maui. Now, this we're going to use a third-party component, and that is Syncfusion. Syncfusion is a third-party which has a lot of components that we can use in our mobile app development. And today we're going to talk about using one component known as autocomplete. So we're going to start everything from scratch up to the finishing line. I have my project created, and if I run this project, that is what I have. You see, when you create a new project in Maui, that is what you have. And I have my emulator selected, and also I've run, and that is a project, or that is a display I have now. So let's go in there now, download or install this Syncfusion package as a NuGet package, and let's start configuring it to use the component. So to do this, let's go to Solution Explorer. So first of all, I have to close this, the debugging mode, and I'll go to dependencies and click on manage NuGet packages. There is a guide to this when you go to syncfusion.com. Okay, so you see that is a autocomplete here, and as you can see, this is what you actually want to get. Now, with this documentation, what we need to do here is we have to search for this syncfusion.maui.input, then we install that package. So let's go to our project here. Now in our project, we're going to search for browse and syncfusion.maui.input. So we search for this, then we install this package. So after the installation, what else can we do? We have to go to the mariprogram.cs and add this to the project. So let's copy this and let's go to let's apply. Okay, so now it is done. When we check the output, we see finished. Now, when you click on the platform and you go for the Android, and let's see, let's go for dependencies instead, then Android, and let's see packages. And you must have syncfusion.maui.input, as you can see, and that is this one. Okay, so it means you have application or the package installed. So now let's close this and let's go back to the mariprogram.cs file. Let's open it, and now here we need to use this. Let's paste what we copied, and with this we have to add some namespace to this. So what is the namespace that we need to add? And you can see it is already added. Okay, so when you check this, once you have this, the next thing we can do is we can include this namespace. So let's grab this namespace, let's go to our project, and you know, with this, let's save. You want to do it in the main program.cs. So in here, let's add the namespace to this. So the space that you add in here is called editor, and let's check the next one. So after adding this namespace, you know, here we can add the contact, or we can bind this content page dot our content. Then we're going to pass in this editor. Okay, so this is what we are going to do here. So let's grab this and let's go to the page here. So all this, we can clear this because we don't need this for now, and let's paste this. So content page dot content. And now the editor, the variable that we created to hold our namespace, we use that to grab our SF autocomplete. We give it a name, as autocomplete. Okay, so after doing this, what's the next thing to do? Let's see. Now, when you check this documentation, we can create a class here. And here it is using a social media as an example. But maybe you can decide to create a different thing altogether. Not social media, but you can decide to create different thing. So let's see how to go about this. Now, you can see that here, we have to bind the source here, right? So this is what we're going to do. Instead of this, we are going to install a community2kit.mbvm as a package. So go to our project. So let's install this community2kit.mbvm. And we have to make sure we click on install. And I will make sure we apply, accept it. Okay. So let's go to the output and it is installed. When we check dependencies, Android, and we have it over here, community2kit.mbvm, we have it installed. Okay. So let's close this up. Let's close off. And, you know, in this, let's create a folder. Now let's name this as view model. So view models. Now let's create a view model here. So let's create a class. And since this class is going to relate to this main page, we want to say main page view model. So main page view model. So this main page view model, in order to inherit from this package that we installed, here must be public and partial class, so we can inherit from observable objects. So observable objects. Okay. So we have this inherited from this. And what we can do here is we can create another model, and that's going to be for our class. So let's create a folder here, and this is models. So this models, we want to grab a country list. Okay, so let's add a class, and now this class is going to be country. So this country, you know, this might be public, but it's a class that we are creating. And clear this off. And you want to have ID and maybe country name. Okay, so this is what you want to grab, maybe ID and country name, or you can actually grab only the name. Well, so we save this. Let's go to our view model, and we want to say, so let's create constructor here. Then we can say observable collection. So observable collection, then we pass in this country, then we say countries, then in here we say countries. So countries, so we can pass in this observable property on top. Then, so we can have countries is equal to new observable collection of this country. So let's populate this here, and we can use this keyword, meaning referring to this object here. So this dot countries, then you know this a list, so we can add. Then in adding of this, we can create a new list of country. So we can close this, and in here we can say new country. So this new country, what is the ID here? The ID is 1. And what is the name? So we can have a name of, let's say, Ghana. Now let's, you can grab this and paste it a couple of times. So let's paste this. Okay, now let's change this to we have Nigeria. We can add this to a list. So let's populate it over here. So let's assume we have this list here. Let's maintain this. So we have this list. Okay. So this country list contains how many lists here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lists here. So we have the list as country. So how can we use this? Let's go to the main page. Code behind file. Now in here, we can clear all this because we don't need any of this. We've cleared it already. And here, let's inject the view model. So we say main page view model. And we say this. So let's bind this to the context. So we say binding context is equal to this view model. And now with this view model, let's grab this, let's go to maui-program.cs and let's register this view model. So we say builder.services.addSingleton, then we call this main page view model. So main page view model, then we add the same thing to builder.services.addSingleton. Then we say main page. We add this. Okay. Now in here, once we've bound it to this page, let's go to the main page, the example file. Now let's add a namespace to this. So we're going to say X and X. So X and S, and now we say view model is equal to namespace. Then we're going to use demo dot view model. So we need to add this view model so we can have access to the list of objects here. Now the next thing that we can do, let's see, when we check this, you know, we have to add the item source to this. Okay, so let's add the item source. So once you have this SF autocomplete, we can still have an item source, and I reset this to binding. Then we add to the countries. So let's see. Okay, so once we added this, we have to X data type, then we're going to say this view model dot main page view model, and now let's add the countries here. So you see we have this countries list. Let's set the width of this. So width request, let's set this to 250. So when you check our model name, we have two properties here. Now which one is supposed to use? So let's specify that. And in doing that, we have to set the display member path and also the test member path. So let's grab this. Let's grab it here. Let's go to our page, our program, Maui, and here let's specify this here. So we have the display member path as name and our test member path as name. Clear this off. Let's set this to vertical stack layout. So let's say this vertical stack layout. Now pages here. You can see I have the list here, Ghana. I have the pop-up. If I type in, I have Benin. If I type in, I have Nigeria, Niger, etc. Right. Let's see if we have a lot of things again to check. Now we have the test member path set already, as you can see from here. So aside from this, maybe if you want event handler, maybe as soon as I type in Ghana and I select Ghana, it might display something. Then we can actually go in there. There are a lot of properties that we can configure it. Example, a selection change. So here, let's generate an event handler. And when we go to this factory, we have the event handler here, and we can display something like display alert, or we can say shell.current.displayAlert. So there's going to be an, let's say, autocomplete. And so before this runs, let's go here and let's add selected value path. And here we can grab, if you want to grab the name or the ID, let's grab the name. Let's try this. So we ask X name, and now we say this is auto complete. So dots, and let's go for selected value because you set the value already. So selected value, then we can convert this to string. So before we do this, maybe this is what we can check for now. We can count this and say if, and maybe autocomplete dot selected value is not equal to now. That is where you want to display this. Now we save this and let's run this and see. Okay, so let's test this and see. So I'm passing Ghana here, and let's see. So yeah, I have the name Ghana. Okay. That is it for this video. I hope this video we've covered how to use the autocomplete, and also when selection changes, how to grab the current selected value. So that is it for this video. If you like what I'm doing, you can give me a thumbs up. Also subscribe to the channel so that as soon as a new lesson drops, you have a notification. Thank you, and take care of yourself, and I'm going to catch you in the next video.